Hello and welcome to MediSimplified. What if I say that a child recovering or recovered from COVID-19 is in more danger as compared to a child who is suffering or is having an active infection of COVID-19? Yes, you heard it right. A child recovering from COVID-19 is in more danger as compared to a child who is suffering from an active infection of COVID-19. Now, children are suffering from a dreadful post-COVID complication abbreviated as MISC, that is Multisystem Inflammatory Syndrome in children. So to know more about the syndrome, let's watch this video together. Hello, my name is Dr. Shubham Mishra, and in this video, I'm going to talk about MISC. C, that is Multisystem Inflammatory Syndrome in children. A new syndrome with the name of Multisystem Inflammatory Syndrome is being seen in children with the clinical features like unremitting fever, red rash all over the body, red eyes, etc., with an epidemiological linkage with the SARS-CoV-2, that is COVID-19. This disease is commonly seen in a child of age group 2 years to 15 to 17 years of age. It is assumed that this syndrome is seen in children, in those children who had got no proper treatment or have not been treated with the COVID-19 infection properly. Usually, all the child who suffer from COVID-19 infection have mild or asymptomatic infection. So they recover from COVID-19 and later antibodies are produced in them, and there is a possibility of post-COVID complications to be seen in them. One of them is MISC, right? So MISC usually occurs after 2 weeks to two months in a child who has recovered from COVID-19. And as this disease is very lethal, it is very important that early diagnosis is done of this disease so that we could have a better prognosis. Now let's talk about the clinical features of this syndrome. MISC, what it does, it can limit the blood supply to the vital organs, leading to the damage of those organs. And the organs which are commonly affected with this syndrome are heart, brain, kidney, lungs, GID, and the most commonly skin, right? So depending upon which organ is involved, the clinical symptoms will be seen, the clinical features will be seen. But the commonly seen clinical features are fever increased more than 24 hours, high fever, and that too more than 38 degrees Celsius, increased heart rate, increased respiration rate, decreased urination, abdominal pain, and the child will have red or cracked lips, red rashes will be present all over the body, enlarged lymph node while palpating, and nausea and vomiting will be seen in the child, and also the child's hands and feet will be swollen. So these are the clinical features which will be seen in the child suffering from MISC. Right. So this symptoms is manageable. Okay. But there are few warning symptoms, right, which if seen, you should run to the emergency department of any hospital as soon as possible. So then let's know what are those emergency or warning signs. So these are the warning signs. Severe abdomen or chest pain, right? If the child says that the abdomen or chest pain is uncontrollable, unbearable, if he is having breathing difficulty in front of you, you can see him gasping, or the way he is doing the respiration or the breathing is abnormal, right? And the child is having new confusion. The child's skin is pale or gray in color, or he or she is having persistent diarrhea, or he is unable to wake up, or he is having an inability to stay awake, right? He is very sleepy. So this all are the warning signs of MISC, and you should run to the emergency department of the hospital nearby you or inform your doctor as soon as possible. Now let's know how we diagnose this syndrome, right? So first of all, a child with age group 0 to 19, or you can call him adolescent, with a fever more than 3 days and more than 38 degrees Celsius, is having any of two from the following 5 things, that is rash or bilateral non-purulent conjunctivitis or mucopurulent mucocutaneous inflammation signs, in hand, feet, or in mouth. The child is in hypotension or shock. The features of myocardial dysfunction, pericarditis, valvulitis, or anything related to heart abnormalities is seen, right? And if there is a evidence of coagulopathy by PT, APTT, or D dimers is elevated, or there is an acute GI problem like diarrhea, vomiting, or abdominal pain. If any two out of this five is present, plus elevated markers, inflammatory markers like ESR, CRP, or precalcitonin, procalcitonin, or you, and plus along with this thing, there should be no obvious microbial cause of all this inflammation. You should rule out those things also, and also to tell it that it is MISC due to COVID. You should have a evidence of COVID-19 positive earlier, or likely to contact, likely that the child is in contact with the patient, or the parents are in suffering from COVID-19. So any of this thing present, first the child age is important, right? With fever more than 3 days, then out of these five things, that is rash, right? Hypotension or shock, myocardial infarction, heart involvement, evidence of coagulopathy, and acute GI problem. Any two out of these five, then elevated inflammatory markers, confirmation of that the child was suffering from COVID-19, and also ruling out other microbial causes, right? No obvious microbial cause of the inflammation should be present. So this is how we diagnose the patient or the child with MISC. These four are the differential diagnosis of the MISC. One is active COVID-19 disease. To rule out, you should have antibody test, or you should have a RTP. If the child is RTPCR positive currently, then it is active COVID-19 case. If he is having antibodies present for COVID-19, then it is post COVID complication MISC. Kawasaki disease is also a differential diagnosis. Also, the symptoms seen in the child of MISC is similar to toxic shock syndrome, or the child can be in sepsis. So these are the differential diagnosis for the MISC syndrome. Now, if we talk about the prevention of MISC, it is very important that the child should not suffer from COVID-19 infection itself. That is the best prevention. And to prevent the COVID-19 infection, either the child should be vaccinated, or all the COVID-19 safety and hygiene protocol should be maintained. The vaccines are not available for the children in most of the part of the country. Few countries have done the trial on the children with the age group more than 12 years of age. So unfortunately, the child having age less than 12, there will be no vaccine available right now. So it is important that all the hygiene protocols have been maintained by the child, not by the child, by the parents. They look after the hygiene or safety protocols for the child. So that is how we can prevent MISC, by preventing COVID-19 infection itself. Now let's talk about the management of this MISC syndrome. First, very important is that the child should be given supportive care in the NICU if he's a neonate, he or she is a neonate, or in PICU, that is pediatric ICU. First, what we do, we give methylprednisolone 1 to 2 mg per kg for a day, and we give IV immunoglobins, IVIG, that is IV immunoglobins, 2 kg per kg over 24 to 48 hours. If there is no improvement seen in the child, we'll repeat IV immunoglobins with or without high dose of MPS. That is, and the high dose means it is 10 to 30 mg per kg for 3 to 5 days. Either we can repeat both together, or we can choose either IVIG or MPS. This is how we do. Now, once you give steroid for 3 to 5 days, we start tapering the dose over 2 to 3 weeks. Right. Also, we can give aspirin or enoxaparin if there is a chances of coagulopathy. What are the indication of aspirin and enoxaparin? I will discuss it shortly. And if the child is having cardiac involvement, it is very important to do the ECG after every 2 days or 48 hourly, I'll say. And also, due to if there is a cardiac involvement, it's very important that you repeat echocardiogram every 7 to 14 days after recovering from MISC2. Now, about the indication of aspirin and enoxaparin and the doses. Aspirin indication is thrombocytosis or coronary aneurysm, Z score more than or equal to 2.5. And the doses for aspirin will be 3 to 5 mg per kg per day and maximum we can give 81 mg in a day to a child. And the next was enoxaparin. Enoxaparin indication is coronary aneurysm, Z score more than 10, or thrombosis or LVF more than 35%. LVF less than 35%. And the doses is 1 mg per kg twice daily subcutaneously, and preferably monitor the factor 10A level, and it should be, the range should be 0.5 to 1. So this was the indication for aspirin and enoxaparin and the doses. So that was all I had to talk about MISC, that is multisystem inflammatory syndrome in children. I hope this video is useful to everyone. So thanks for watching this video. Hope you like it. Do like, share and subscribe my channel MediSimplified. Thank you.